versus Willow!
You're in far over your head, infiltrator.
I know the truth. You're necromancers, all of you.
Hey guys, welcome back to some more heroic duels. I'm playing some weapon rogue today. Because I've been seeing a lot of mages out there, rogue is pretty good against mage. Up against warlock here in the first matchup. I think we keep the deadly weapons. I don't know about Swindle. The cutting class is like guaranteed card draw with the deadly weapons, so maybe we just do this.
They're not trapped. They're my friends.
Almost out of time. High place, stay shot.
I think this is what we do here. If he plays the Lucky Soul, we have the prize Plunderer with the cutting class. Otherwise, I just ping this 2-1 with the Prize Plunderer. Okay. Well, I think I would actually rather have the card draw.
My blade stays sharp!
That's lethal.
My blade stays sharp.
Yeah, I think it was right to go for the card draw as soon as possible, and he just didn't do anything for all those turns. So I figured he had spells in hand, which is why I went for the counter spell there. I think let's just take the early game tempo. Well, double field contact with Octovod is pretty good, and Neophyte is not a bad card either. So I think I'm down for the middle bucket here. Spirit of the Shark is too slow. Leeroy is a consideration, but this gets worse as the run goes on, while this stuff gets better as we get further in the run and we pick up our second passive. So playing for later in the run, I think we take this.
Lillian versus Omu.
Witness the ways of my force.
Are you trying to ruin my espionage?
So, Token Druid is a tough one for Rogue, no doubt. We're definitely going to want to keep prep for this to get a weapon out on turn one. I'm not sure about keeping Wicked Stab. Like, we could use it together with the prep. I think we toss back Secret Passage and Krastinov. Like, we may not draw a spell to use with the prep is the thing, so I might want to keep this. Main issue being that it is one of the ways we get home on damage in the end. And without having that finishing damage, we may not be able to kill him before he does something crazy.
My blade stays sharp. My blade stays sharp.
So we're definitely hero powering next turn, so I'm gonna swing here. I'm gonna clear two minions off this, and let the Secret of Justice deal with the 4-4. What is it called? Judgment of Justice. Okay.
My blade stays sharp.
That is pretty nice. Stick another one back in there. Oh man. Alright, we're getting kind of lucky here.
My blade stays sharp!
Bring me their tusks!
Next turn should be able to kill him, I think.
Blade
with him doing that, but this isn't really getting him anywhere.
Growing strong.
You're off to good.
Yeah, Mancric is pretty good in Rogue in the early part of a run. That is for sure. Now let's take the coins for combo activators. We want to get that dagger up early. This is perfect for that. These buckets, though, very poor. I mean, all of these have drawbacks to my deck, so it's kind of like Sea Giant is a dead card, and these cards are just bad. Over here, we have the Cavern Finder, I mean, the Shiny Finder, who I don't have a weapon in the deck right now. Maybe we could pick up a weapon later, and this will be better. But we don't really want to be picking up weapons having the hero power we do. And over here we have the Skulking Geist in a deck where I have a bunch of one mana spells. Guess we can go with the Steel Dancer, but I really don't like these two cards.
Lillian versus Lillian.
Are you trying to ruin my espionage? No, but you're ruining mine.
So I've been seeing some people running this hero power with like a mill rogue. I think we probably should be able to do pretty well against that. But let's look for our deadly poison. I mean deadly weapons. Octobot's not bad, I guess. Looks like something else different completely. Cthune Rogue. Oh wow, we get the rigged fair game. That is pretty nice. Well, don't really want him activating. I think let's do this. Then we can go off with the field contact if we get this stuff discounted. I didn't want the 1-1 setting off the Noble Sacrifice. We could get better value out of that later. So I think this is what we do here.
Give me that! Look what I won!
Initiating overdrive.
It's quiet. Too quiet.
Almost out of time.
Dysfunctional.
My blade stays sharp.
I mean, the odds of him being able to kill this field contact aren't the highest, so if it gets another turn, this game's over.
I am so chaos.
I guess he's testing for Counterspell. He probably has like Maw of C'thun. No, the Heart of C'thun. Double time rogue, let's go. It's not great with the Abyss and Wicked Stab, but oh, we get, there's some good stuff we could do here. Yeah. So, having the double time, I really want to find weapon buffs, like Deadly Poison becomes plus 4 attack then, and the Deadly Weapons. If we get that off on the weapon, the game is over if they don't have weapon removal. Let's take the early game removal here, I think.
Lillian versus Rattlegore!
I'll put you out of your misery.
Well, I think let's keep Mancrick and Swindle here. We could coin out the Mancrick on one. And obviously the card draw effects are pretty strong with the double time. Alright, definitely would not mind getting Mancrick double.
Please,
Is he gonna play one more card? No. Maybe I should have swung there.
Almost out of time.
Could brain freeze this.
My blade stays sharp.
Maybe one of them doesn't want the brain freeze though. I think this game shows, though, that I might have a little bit of trouble against Disc of Light and Warrior. Like, I think we're pretty good here. But if we go up against Disc of Legend, we could get run over pretty easily.
Stay sharp.
Oh, man. I guess it's the Locust. Like, that's a double time? We get two copies of it back? Betrayal could be pretty good with double time, too.
Lillian versus Slate!
Oh, hey! Are you a new professor?
Are you trying to ruin my espionage?
Alright, so let's keep the Mancrick again. Price Plunderer could be good, but let's look for some card draw, I think. Alright, the Silverleaf Poison is pretty good. We can draw four cards with that. Maybe more if we get some more weapon durability charges. Up against the new Cannibalism. Interested to see how this does here. Okay, Mirror Entity is nice. Auto tempo. Oh, baby. That is great. Just gonna get this up now so we can Silverleaf next turn. What an insane opener. Oh my god. I don't think I'm gonna shadow step it yet. We could do that next turn. Oh, I'm shocked he can actually kill it here. Well, it doesn't really matter. We didn't really need another one in the deck there. I think we already got basically enough tempo here to do whatever we want. Might even just be able to shadow step that if I land like a deadly poison next turn on the weapon, bringing it up to 6 attack. I mean, he's gonna be dead.
Return to the field.
Dang, yeah, that was some kind of opener there. Well, you know, the Surly Mob removed two minions for 3 mana. So I don't really like the backstabbing chorus because they can hit our own minions. But maybe it's the play here. Because these other buckets are not great. Okay, I guess Headcrack is okay. Yeah, maybe we just want the damage.
Lillian versus Willow!
You're in far over your head, infiltrator. I know the truth. Your necromancers, all of you!
Alright, I think let's look for our better stuff here. Card draw, deadly weapons, bag of coins is good. Not bad. It sucks that the snipes can hit that. But we can dagger down the imp here.
Out of time. My blade stays sharp.
Hopefully we can find a little bit more of battle cries or something here to draw.
Stay sharp!
This is actually really inconvenient that we don't have anything to play here. It's gonna feel a little bit like a waste just throwing this away, but let's hope we draw something we can play next turn. That is something I can play.
My blade stays sharp.
that's disgusting. Double time, man. Double time. Well, now, this is a lot of value. I think just because we do have the shiny finder, actually. Maybe this is good enough with the double spells. I like the Mimic Pod, but the Burgle could give us a lot of stuff that we can't play. I'm gonna go the poisons, only because we have the shiny finder. This will pull us the shank. The shank isn't great, but with the silver leaf poison, it's actually, you know, a lot of card draw.
Lillian versus Rattlegore.
I'll put you out of your misery.
Man, we keep going second here. Would like to have the bear coins going first, but can't really complain. Let's look for card draw with this. Or the locust. Locust is cool too. Up against the new Rally the Troops. Oh man, he's not gonna give us any chance here to, bag of coins. Oh, I should have pinged my own. Oh, I'm stupid. I should have pinged Octobot. That was stupid of me.
Please help me find
him. Well, looks like it's not really gonna matter here. Unless he trades this into the 3-2. Come on, hit the Octobot. I think we just locust here.
Dysfunctional.
My blade stays sharp.
Shot.
Gruesome children of the Horde. Please help me find Orgrim.
Do I have enough mana for lethal here? Let's see, 8, 9, 10, 1 mana off. Still shit. Actually, oh no, yeah, this is not enough.
My blade stays sharp!
Let's just stick the wife in there.
We are friends now. Hello, friend.
Unity, precision, perfection.
That doesn't really matter. Alright, we're getting pretty lucky these games, getting these coins. These games are too easy with the double time and coins. Sure, I want draw 4 cards and gain 8 armor. Four cards. And we pass.
Lillian versus Elucia.
Get out of my school, trespasser!
Aiding Kel'Thuzad will destroy your family.
Well, going second again. I think I'm gonna keep all of the card draw. Oh.
Stay sharp.
Job's done.
feel like we almost have too much value here. Not really gonna get a chance to play all these cards, I don't think. In time to play the Looming Presence, like this might have to come down much later. Or maybe we just throw away a Field Contact. Oh man.
My blade stays sharp.
Give me that. Love what I
think. Let's make the weapon here. Since I think I want to go steal the answer next turn. Man, this is tricky. Alright, let's just play
May
this.
I have this dance?
Ooh, let's melt some faces!
Guarantee! My blade stays sharp! You don't pick the ones. My blade stays sharp.
Victory for Sylvanas.
Man, do we want to play this now? Kind of want to play it now before it's just like impossible to play.
Once out of here.
I'm
almost out of time.
I think I'm gonna have so much card draw. I can't. Well, I don't really mind if he's using HP here.
The void is filled with many whispers. Waltz out of here.
Guaranteed magic.
My blade stays sharp.
Too much value. But a nice game, though. Oh, and we're definitely taking nothing here. Like, keeping this deck as small as possible, I really like it. Let's us hit our Locust and our coin and the bag of coins more often.
Lillian versus Fireheart.
I won't go easy on you. I just like imitators. Are you trying to ruin my espionage?
I think we can keep Brain Freeze. Maybe not, though. But if this is some kind of shaman that wants to get on the board early, we might need this. Oh, that is a hand of nothing, though.
My blade stays sharp.
All right, that does
My
help.
My blade stays sharp.
Maybe I should have shadow stepped there. Wait, what? That procs that? Yeah, we're definitely gonna need some card draw.
Nature waits for no one but me.
May I have this dance? My blade stays sharp! The calm before the storm.
Oh, that is perfect.
Mm-hmm. blade stay sharp.
I do have to watch how much damage I'm taking here. Oh man, I guess I'm dead. Just got outsmorked here. Well, nothing we can do about that one.
I tried my best.
Supposed to be here.
Try to keep quiet, would you?
Oh, nice here. So, looking for card draw. Cthune Paladin, okay.
My blade stays sharp.
Oh, we have this terrible combo again.
The light protects me.
Look! No shinies!
My blade stays sharp!
The light dims, but we fight.
My blade stays sharp.
Maybe I'm valuing these coins too much. Maybe we should just be trying to get enough space in our hand for this looming presence. I think he is incentivized to go face here, though.
The light dims, but we fight.
Thank you.
My blade stays sharp.
No, take shiny.
So let's think here. Next turn, I draw. I'll have 8 cards in hand. If I want to play this, I'm going to have to throw a coin away here. Sadly. Yeah, that works out. Let's see if he's got the sword here. I think we can go paralytic poison next turn to buff up the weapon a little bit. But if he has greatsword, that changes. Looks like he doesn't have it. Definitely want the refreshing spring water, I think. Whoa.
Out of time.
I think I actually want to buff this weapon up more.
Consider this a house call. Fire! Nuts, cleaver! shot.
Job's done.
I think next turn maybe we play the Fireheart.
I do love a good study session.
Depends how crazy his board gets here.
Never be afraid of your inner power. Almost out of time. My blade stays sharp.
I think we just really had to get as much of that board dead as possible. If I can get to my locust, then we pretty much win.
Put your faith in the light.
I can forge that.
May I have this dance?
I bleed for confirmation.
Stay sharp. Hands on experience.
So that's 6 plus 4 from the Abyss. I could do 10 from hand right now. Could also play Secret Passage to hit some more damage, probably.
To Northrend.
Well, let's see if he has a taunt here. Very nice, very nice.
Efficient is sufficient.
My stay sharp.
Yeah, we just, we're not gonna take any of this.
Lillian versus Mozaki!
You look suspicious. I will write you up. I will fight every teacher here if I have to.
Up against Mage here, we definitely want to look for our weapon buffs. And we don't want to keep any of that. Weapon buffs, card draw. Not a good hand.
Stay sharp!
I think we're always going to hero power next turn because we want to draw cards with this panther.
I got this.
Oh man, this is a tough game. Maybe I'll secret passage next turn.
Someday I'll be
really don't want the secret
you.
Passage to be the first card we play in the turn though.
We have many.
So I'm gonna guess this is like a Mordresh thing with the double battle cry. Didn't do that in the right order. These draws could be better. The 4-3 will die to the Reckoning at least.
Stay sharp.
Job's done.
I'm almost out of time.
Well, he's going to be able to make a lot of 1-1s, of mana worms here, I mean. But I'm just looking to end the game. End the game before Mordresh, I mean. What are we, one damage off? That's annoying. Oh, I don't know what to do here. Gonna have to come up with something quick. God, I can't believe he still has this stupid totem up too. And we're dead to Mordresh. But I didn't really have an option there, I think. Alright, he doesn't have Mordresh. I think we can pull this off then. Alright, we got him.
My blade stays sharp.
Alright, so having another weapon is good for the shiny finder. And these other two options aren't really what I want. The weapon isn't really what I want either, but I guess the durability is kind of nice if we land, like, the draw poison on it or something like that. I just don't think this is enough value.
Won't go easy on me. I dislike imitators. Are you trying to ruin my espionage?
Alright, this hand interests me. Let's keep the betrayal as some removal. Oh, I hadn't really thought about this with the new Rally of the Troops. This definitely makes Battlecry Shaman a lot more formidable. These are some good things to have here, though. Let's get the Wand Thief out, since maybe it'll proc the Oasis allies here. These would be rogue secrets, so not as good. But this can also damage our own face if we play first. I think we still take it. That is what I wanted to see right there.
I know when I lost.
Yeah, that is a hard one for the base shaman to beat, for sure. Alright, and another pass. Our deck is really, really small. Like, shockingly small for this far in the run.
Lillian versus Illusia!
Get out of my school, trespasser!
Aiding Kel'Thuzad will destroy your family!
Alright, let's see what we got here. Gonna keep the silver leaf, of course. So, definitely the spell discount is pretty formidable. We're gonna play the silver leaf next turn. What is this? Trash. I guess maybe this could be kind of useful. Maybe here. So, might go exercise or deadly poison next turn. I mean, that would make a pretty big weapon. And we can get the... Potentially, we could steal damage the next turn. Could Krastinov, too. Well, that's pretty bad for us.
Victory for Sylvanas.
We will feed on this world.
almost out of time.
May I have this dance?
Twisted.
My blade stays sharp.
I don't want to shadow step this because if he has Shadow Word Void, I really don't want the pings to be able to kill me. I want something on board to absorb the hits here, so I need that 4-4. Like that, it just saved me there. Now, whether we have enough damage here is another thing. So let's see, this is 16, 20. Oh, we got it.
Give me that! Look what I want!
So keeping the 4-4 on board there just saved our lives and let us win this game. Awesome, we go 12 wins with Rogue. Double time Rogue worked out super well there. I am really happy with this run. We just lost that one game where we got so far behind against the Face Shaman, which is always a tough matchup for Rogue. But yeah, that was really easy towards the end. A very, very good run. Rogue looking pretty strong right now. Been seeing more mages lately and more slower decks that are not Armor Warrior. Like, you don't want to be facing Armor Warrior as the Rogue. And I haven't really been seeing too much of that. And against these other decks that are just kind of slow to get going early on in the run, Rogue is a pretty consistent 3-0 at this point. I mean, I don't see anyone playing the Weapon Rogue, so I think it's kind of like a bit of a secret right now. But let me tell you guys this secret. Weapon Rogue can get to 3 wins very easily. It's a very safe class to pick as far as tier 2 classes go. If you don't get offered the Warrior, you don't get offered the Priest. Falling down to Rogue is not that bad. It'll get you back to your 3 wins pretty easily, pretty consistently. And sometimes it can just go the distance if you get the Keldalar, or if you get offered a crazy second passive like this one. So all in all, Rogue, you know, it's going to be a high win average, even though you won't get to 12 wins that often. I still think Rogue is definitely worth picking as a tier 2 class right now. But that's going to do it for today. Thank you guys for joining me. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you come back for more next time. I'll see you guys then. Have a great day.